All right, guys, so here on Wrestlevlogs, we have an interview with
Jeremiah Wilkerson.
Alright, Jeremiah, can you kind of like introduce yourself more to the viewers who may be tuning in for the first time?
I am part co-owner with Santa Rosa and Brian Toronto. Where are we at? Like 2 years now? About 2 years.
Okay.
Going on, but this is our debut event officially. This all women. The last two we had. I don't know if you were there, but you were.
No, the last one. Sadly, I wasn't there. Sadly.
Yeah, we had men on the last year. We even had dinner.
Right on.
Yeah, we're making history tonight. So.
Right on. How you feel, man? Any like pre-match thoughts about the show coming up or about the card in general?
I'm just ready to make history. I'm ready. Hopefully we can start trending. We stretch it over. Hopefully we can start trending on Twitter. Hashtag Hell Has No Fury. But yeah, the whole card is stacked. Like, this is like super ending too. Like the talent, we have what, three from AEW, Kurgan, Ross, you got Thunder Rosa, you got Pixel, you got Red Velvet. So, like, where else are you gonna get such a card for money?
Other than here on Mission for Hope.
Exactly.
Now, you did mention Thunder Rosa's recent AEW debut. Can I kind of get your thoughts on that? What you thought about her debut against Hikaru Shida?
I started just now. I don't know, I got pretty emotional. Because, I mean, I've known it was coming for about 3 or 4 weeks in advance that I knew it was going to be on there. And when actually seeing her, like, walk out, I got pretty choked up. But yeah, I don't know if you watched it. Well, no. They completely.
They tore the house down. I don't want to say it was awesome hype for the whole car, but when I saw that announcement, same thing, God damn, San Antonio legend, wrestling legend, Thunder Rosa, on AEW. Like, holy shit, that's a huge ass opportunity right there, you know?
Yeah.
That's not something that's
walk in there, NWA champion for another month and still.
Exactly. Still.
Still.
And she had a match against Steve Lee recently, too, right? She had a match against Eagle too recently.
Yeah.
On AEW, too.
And I only saw a part of that actually on YouTube, and I watched part of it, but I got too busy with this.
It happens. This is just.
Did you watch that match?
I did.
Was it good to see
it? It was up there. It was close. If you had to ask me, I'd really have to think about it. It was good. I mean.
Testing.
That's my train of thought because of that. But no, I mean, I've been a fan of Evil East too, ever since her days in Lucha Underground.
I'm
a really huge fan of her, and, you know, it's a dream match about Thunder Rosa versus Evil East, La Sicaria versus La Mera Mera, like, they're really good, and I'm hoping we can see more Thunder Rosa in AEW.
Hello?
Well, I mean,
is that good for everybody? Is this good for everybody?
I have on the card right now, but I just shared a graphic from AEW where they're actually going to have a tag team match next week.
Oh, wow.
Her and Sheena versus.
I know we kind of touched a little bit about this in the podcast, but since not everyone listens to the podcast, which y'all should, can you kind of go more briefly into your backstory and how you kind of got to be working merch and working with Thunder Rosa in general?
I met her because y'all have actually been on my radio show. I have a radio show, Shattered Glass Radio, KZSM.org. Another guy from Hill Face Wrestling. Podcast Hill Face Wrestling. But the dude that runs that was like, hey, I want you to meet Thunder Rosa. So, like, I was doing, at the time, we were doing a radio promotion with Farmer's Park in San Marcos. And so, like, I met Thunder Rosa out there, and we kind of hit it off there. And then I met Brian, we hit it off more. And then I went to the Sabotage show, because they used to run Sabotage in Austin. And, like, I started promoting for them, taking flyers and stuff. And lo and behold, like, we just slowly became, well, actually, came close to family. So, yeah, I started hanging flags with him for a month ago. So, yeah, on wrestling road trips. Or I started just selling merch. And then I'd just go on road trips. One thing led to another.
Now you're here, running. Now you're running shows with her in Mission Pro,
right? Yeah.
No, and you know, kind of just since you are a Mission Pro wrestling after all, what are your kind of future hopes for Mission Pro?
Just keep making history. I mean, this is our first show, and I don't know if y'all have been on Twitter recently.
It's sold out. It's sold out. Completely sold out.
It sold out pretty quick, actually. You know, I mean, we could have kept selling more, but obviously, limit doctor. Even for, like, I don't even know what we're holding right now. We're actually over the 1.8 and it just made
it. Oh, really? Wow. Are there any specific wrestlers you want to bring in, specifically to Mission Pro? What's up your head?
I personally would like to see Allison Kay from NWA. Who, Thunder Rosa, actually won the NWA championship in our time. Well, I mean, that's what I do too.
So. Yeah.
I'll flip the tables on you.
Shoot, that's a really good one. I mean, besides Allison Kay is another one.
Marty Bell, I'd like to see Marty Bell.
If she wasn't signed to the Impact, I would like to see Tennille Dashwood or Emma.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
If she wasn't signed to Impact, I would love to see her here. Holidays on commentary tonight, right?
Right.
I'd love to see her in action too. At a feature point.
Oh yeah.
We saw her walking past it, and I was like, oh, that's Holiday. And I had to like do a double take for a minute. What? I think she's a free agent right now, but Kelly Klein's another one.
Yeah.
Ever go up against Thunder Rosa, they both have that MMA background.
Right.
They could put on a real barn burner there. That's another one, but
I mean, this list goes on and on. Like, everybody from NWA. Oh, you know, another one I'd like to see is Danny. Danny Jordan, is that right?
I think so. The name sounds familiar.
Yeah. He was actually at, I believe, Brian and Thunder's first or last match.
Right on.
Yeah, there's a lot of it. We can potentially go.
Typo negative.
Hell yeah.
I'm a huge Typo fan. Like, we just got done with the podcast. You know me and my music background, my music. In fact, Matt behind the camera, he's just the bassist in our band.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that we never got off the ground.
Matt could just make music?
It was more. Matt, what did you call it? Shitty punk rock?
Yeah.
Shitty punk rock, it was low quality. Like, we literally recorded off of Matt's phone. No recording equipment, I yelled into a microphone for like 5 minutes. He played some bass riffs, and then we just kind of called it that. No one wants to hear those recordings, I promise you that much. There is Roz rocking in. But,
hey, as long as you're having fun.
Oh yeah, it was fun. We did a. You can find this on SoundCloud. We did a.
On the end of your band.
The original name was we had a hardcore punk band. It was called a Baca Place. Then we had a side project where it was me yelling and Matt playing ukulele. We called it Island Need of a Home. It was basically a ukulele concert pretty much. And singing about basically getting stranded on an island and having no government on an island. rolling that shit. It's on SoundCloud. It's really bad though. You don't want to hear that though.
I'm gonna have to look it up.
I'll send you a link. Maybe we'll, if you ever do, I ever come on the show, we'll play a little clip here and there. But
I don't know. Yeah, maybe I'll play it on Cataclysm Radio.
I don't know if you're going to like it, but
hey, Lucky is an acquired taste. Like, I don't understand why people like Justin Bieber. Here we are.
Here he is, like, what? Millions years later? He, like, Baby is, like, the most viewed song on YouTube. Most disliked song, too, on top of that. So, you know, it's an audience for something. It's like wrestling, you know? You have people like one style, people like another. People clash on different styles, you know? These are us, like you said. But yeah, any final thoughts before we kind of like wrap this up?
Let
you get back to doing what you're doing?
No, just hopefully everybody tunes in on TidalWaveNetwork.com. Enjoying the feed. We're going to have better lighting this time than last time when we're out back here. I don't know, I just look forward to making it. I can't wait.
Right on,
man.
And where can our viewers find you on any social media? Anything else you want to promote?
Well, you got Carol, my girl, has a show on the same radio station I do, MondayNightWithCarol.com, or you can buy merch at thunderwrestling.net, MissionProWrestling.net. Oh, I better plug that. Yeah, Carol will kick my ass. MissionProWrestling.net. You can order customs on there. Just click customs and follow the directions.
Thank you guys for tuning in. Wrestlevlogs.